This program is brought to you through the kind support of the Friends of That's What She Said. Support BCTV by visiting bctv.org/support.
It used to be great, now it's not so great, but it's still pretty great. Reading. Eight pretzels nonstop and pot pie no top. More dessert till we drop. Burks. Did they really say that? They did not say that. Yeah, they did say that. That's what she said.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us for a night of That's What She Said. You'll notice our friend Jane is not here with us tonight. She's on assignment. I don't know where she's at. But we hope she'll give us a call. I did tweet her, so I'm hoping
good.
She joins us.
I'm glad.
Before we get started, I want to let you know that you can give us a call. We are taking live calls at 610-378-0426, and you can tweet us on She Tweets to Me at Twitter.
Oh, wait. Yeah.
So I'm joined here by my friends.
Martha.
And Nicole.
Hello.
Okay, good. So, yeah, it's just the three of us tonight, but that's
cozy.
It is cozy.
Three's a party.
Three is a party.
Yes.
Speaking of threes, we've had a few celebrity deaths like the last couple of days, right?
Oh, my goodness.
Yes. With Doris Roberts.
Yes.
Prince.
Prince, very sad.
China.
They're not sure that he had a will. Right. Do you not think, even though he was very young, that he would have had a business manager that would have seen that that was
there
all.
Was something.
I would hope so. I mean, he had a lot of assets, you would think.
Oh, I forget how many $1 million they expected.
So that's kind of a shame. It's
very
been
sad.
A strange week
in
celebrity world.
You mentioned China.
Yeah.
And did you hear what was interesting about that? She actually donated her brain to science so that they can study the effects of concussions on the brain.
Oh,
so,
wow,
you know,
that's fascinating.
Yeah, hopefully her
good
death
for
leads
her.
To some good discovery to save people in the future, to help people
absolutely.
In the future. So
that's
thanks,
insane.
China. Good for you.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah. Good.
Are you knitting purple in honor of Prince?
In honor of Prince.
The purple ones.
You know what? I am. Yes. That's exactly what I'm doing
how
here.
Thoughtful,
Sheila.
How thoughtful.
Yeah, good dedication, Sheila.
One, so here I
there
go.
You go.
Purple. We're nuts, I know.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. So let's talk about something a little less crazy. Let's talk about those primaries that are
tomorrow.
Oh,
yeah.
Tomorrow.
Day, right?
I hope people go out and vote. They're really important.
It's really important.
It's really,
yeah.
really important that people vote. I heard so many people say, "Oh, I'm so disgusted. I'm just not going to vote." Oh,
well.
That's
a whole
point.
You should vote.
Exactly.
Exactly. You're disgusted.
That's
good.
Not a very good logic. I mean,
you know, and
even if
you don't want to vote,
it's really important to do so.
And if you don't want to vote for the national, if that so turned you off, the local.
That's what's most important.
That's what's really important.
Yeah, this is the big one. So everybody get out there and vote. If you don't vote, do it.
I'm mad, so don't vote. That's like being shot at. I'm just going to stand here.
Yeah. I'm not going to the hospital because I hate them. I'll just bleed to death.
Come on.
I'm saying, no, I'm not going to vote. Well, that's way to get even. Right?
Yeah. Wow, you're showing us.
Yeah.
Go vote. It doesn't matter who we are going to vote in or what we believe in.
No.
What matters is that you're going to vote and exercise your civil right and also your civil duty to go vote.
It's a civil right that there are so many people in so many parts of the world that would give anything to have that right to vote.
Right. And what do we think about the candidates? I mean, the president candidates? The senator?
Well, I'll tell you about that on my rant.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I'm
not
going
to name any names.
We'll wait on that.
I promise not to name any
You're ahead
any
of that
names,
tree.
Yeah. I think I'm tired of it.
You're
Aren't you tired of it?
I mean, I'm over all of it.
Exactly. And it's not even, it's only April.
There's just
I'm tired of it.
Yeah, it's nonsense.
It is.
Well, it's been a show. It's been a
it's
exactly.
Been a show.
I feel like we're watching Big Brother presidential version.
Exactly.
Like who's gonna do something stupid now?
It's like
kind
a Kardashian
of,
reality show.
It really is.
It's really
and,
ridiculous.
It's rough.
You know, yeah, and even the candidates really you like, at some point you're like, really? Come on.
It's so saturated with
Even I mean, they're stuck in the ring with these monkeys. You never know what's going to fly out of anybody's mouth.
No, you're right.
You just have, I mean, they kind of just have to roll with it, too. Yeah. And they're probably just as frustrated as the rest of us are, right?
I hope
Think
so.
About it.
Oh, I
they're
do hope
stuck
so.
In this with these people. We can shut the TV off, but they can't.
And shut the TV off, I do.
Yeah.
But I did something new this year that I have not done before.
What's that?
For the primaries, I typically go there to vote for the presidential primaries, but then they do all the other balloting stuff too. And I'm just like, oh, okay, well, this name looks fun. Boop, beep, boop, boop, boop.
Voting.
And I realize that if I'm going to walk the walk and talk the talk, I cannot do that. So this year I really sat down and I looked at the candidates' websites and I read through their platforms and read some of their background.
You educated yourself.
I feel a lot more educated. And it took me 15 minutes. And what's really funny is I have a student intern right now who's interning with what I do with the musical and theater arts club and all that. And we're sort of in a lull this week. We're in between musical and us going to Broadway on Friday. And I was like, let's learn about the candidates. So I made him look them up and read them to me. And
right.
I
said that these kids don't know about this stuff. And this might be the only exposure they have to it. So it's good for them
and
to get educated.
And he and I actually had a good conversation about some of it. So I was like, all right, as I'm learning, maybe I'm teaching him too.
They will soon be a voting age. Oh, he is? Okay. So there you go. They
and I actually think that one of the good things that seems to be happening is that the very younger generation, the really new voters in the 20-somethings, really are taking an interest in this, and that's wonderful.
Yeah, I've had
whatever their interest may be, at least they're not being complacent about it. I think that's wonderful.
Not all of them. I mean, there's complacency at every age, but I've had some good conversations with some of my senior students, and I'm really proud of them for that.
I mean, do you educate them on the issues and the things that they're trying to, like,
here and there,
legalize or not legalize?
My subject area doesn't naturally lend to it, but I do mention things. I try not to give them my opinion on too much of things.
You don't want to sway them.
I want them to form, and not just like on politics, but you know, on things in the environment and things that I'm passionate about and that I teach about, I'll try to give them both sides, but I'm like, I'm not, and kids will say, well, what do you think? And I'll say, it's not my job to give you my opinion. It's my job to give you the skills to make your own opinions. I need you to form an opinion, and my opinions are mine. And once you've formed yours, if you want to talk with me, then we can, but I don't want to just give you my opinion. That's not teaching. That's forcing.
Yeah.
So,
and speaking of opinions, what do we think about the possibility of medical marijuana being legalized?
Well, it is.
See, I'm a little out of the loop. She's done. So, yeah, what do we think about that?
I just don't think it's a big issue. I think it's long overdue, frankly. And very honestly, and I'm not going to go into the whole story, when I was 6 years or 4 years old and I started getting asthma, my mother found this stuff she could buy in a can for 45 cents a can at the drugstore called Asthmador. And she would put a little pile of it when I would have my asthma attacks. She'd put a little pile of it and light it, and I would inhale it, and it would relax me, and I'd go to sleep. And for 12 years, till I went to college, that's the only cure that the only thing I had that would relieve my asthma that I would get in fall. It was marijuana.
Oh.
It was marijuana. Nice.
That at the pharmacy?
Yeah, for 20, I think it was 45 cents for like a little can like Golden's Mustard came
and
in.
How old are you?
My whole time's 7 changed.
I used this till I went to college.
No, but I mean, like how old were you when she first gave it to you?
Four.
Four? Oh my
God. But it was just something. What it did was it relaxed me.
What a time!
And then
it was
a long time later, after I was teaching and smelling marijuana, I went home one night and I said, "Mom, that stuff that you used to burn, that Asthmador, do you know what that was?" And she said, "Yeah, it was marijuana."
Whoa. Okay.
Well, it was just one of those things that weren't overdoing it.
No.
It was used, and frankly, it's still the best thing that I've ever used for my asthma.
Clearly, we
can't
buy the story anymore, can we?
Now,
if you notice, Martha breathes like a fan. Thanks, Mom and Asthmador.
There's no wheeze here.
No wheeze here. No. Martha breathes better than anyone I know. Since age 4.
So I don't know. Do I think it's a big deal? No.
It's not.
I don't. I mean, really. with all the other things we should be worried about.
I think there's a lot of bigger fish to fry, yeah, that's for sure.
We make such mountains out of molehills, man, on everything. Yes, yes. Everyone's going to freak out about something. Calm your panties, kids. It's okay.
Yeah. It's not that serious.
It's not that big a deal.
Let's not get our shorts in a
bunch. And you know what? It's not an entry-level drug. It's not, you know, it's not a sure. I never went on to heroin, you know?
Yeah,
and,
that's good.
I just think we have bigger things to worry about when it comes to legalized pharmaceuticals far beyond marijuana. The price of pharmaceuticals and the overprescribing mm-hmm. of pain medicine, high impact pain medicine is just disgusting.
Yeah.
Because that is addictive.
Yeah, it is. Pain medicine is terribly addictive.
Yeah.
Well, good. I mean, you're right. It's not that big of a deal. So. No. People need to worry about the more serious things.
To have asthma attacks, I will certainly look for a practitioner who will give me a prescription.
Don't hesitate.
Write that script.
Oh my goodness. That's so funny.
So I heard, speaking of, you know, cures for stuff, and I don't know if there's a cure for this, but I heard the Zika virus is in Pennsylvania. That's, okay, that's really scary to me, and I've been trying to keep a level head about it, you know, trying not to go crazy, but
it's hard not to.
And my husband and I are thinking about having another baby soon.
Really?
Yeah.
And I'm going to be an aunt?
You're going to be an auntie again.
Again.
And that's a scary thought. I mean, if I do get pregnant, I'm going to wear
this crazy.
I'm going to wrap myself in mosquito netting. Mm-hmm. And, I mean, because, you know, it goes back and forth. They've found a linkage. They have not found, like, a link. There is causal concern. There is not.
Be consistent.
I'm
going to
err on the side of caution and say Zika is going to have some problems for me if I were pregnant.
And still, I heard that today that the some agency has developed a mosquito. They think that they can actually send out. They have modified a mosquito.
Yes.
To send out that will. Do something to other the Zika mosquitoes.
So it's a male mosquito.
And it will venture. It will kill the offspring, or it will do something to stop the.
So what happens is it'll mate with the female, and then the eggs they lay, they will be sterile and die.
So why was there so much objection to this? Because there was huge objection.
Really? I honestly have no idea, but I guess the whole fact that it's GMO
genetically.
That's a major topic these days.
And folks,
we have to give a little.
Once again, making a mountain out of a molehill. Yeah. You have been eating genetically modified organisms
your entire life.
Maybe not, you know, science, but that's how we have all of our vegetables and everything.
Home viewer.
Hello, dears. How are you?
Jane.
Hi.
We've been wondering where you are.
Well, I'm so sorry I couldn't be there. I had to be away, and it's sort of clandestine, so I shan't go into it.
Another one.
It's a secret.
Oh, it was. Actually, there was a tragic accident in the family of my masseuse in Bulgaria, so I had to fly across and comfort him.
Oh, that was nice of you. You're a good
really
friend.
Really, very sad.
Well.
Why am I smiling?
We're just happy to hear from you, that's all. We miss you, but we're happy to hear your voice.
Well, when I'm around Olaf, I smile too. So I assume it's going well.
Jane, we're drinking margaritas tonight.
Oh, my goodness. Well, we'll have to do that again sometime. Oh,
we will.
I know what happens when I drink margaritas, Jane.
I do. Now, you just behave yourself.
A little less than ladylike.
Remember, there are several married men in the house. So I was wondering, because I was told that, can we roll that intro? Well,
boss knows around.
There we go. So I was thinking, since I'm over here in Bulgaria, where I have my spa work done, how do we feel about landscaping of the body type?
It's important. I am a well-tended garden, Jane.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
It's very important. Yeah. Martha's like, no, it's not.
I don't think I'm even going to enter into this one.
Well, I think you should, Martha, because I think, don't you get to a point where it just doesn't matter? Well, not that it doesn't matter, but you just don't really put that much effort into it.
No, you know what? Yeah, there were times in the last couple months that I felt that way, but it's a slippery slope. Once you don't care, you just really don't care. So, no, I haven't gotten quite to that point yet.
All right. Well,
no, a girl.
It is important. No, it really is important.
I'd say yeah, it makes you feel good.
Yeah,
it
absolutely.
Makes you feel good.
Well, that's true. It does. And certainly, when I stand before a mirror, I like seeing that little heart shape carved out. It makes me smile and makes me feel loved.
Yeah. It makes me feel loved. That's good.
Whatever.
Feeling loved is important.
Well, everyone should be loved.
Absolutely.
But the ambulance is leaving now, so I really should get back to Olaf and tend to him. So
give Olaf a leg.
It has been lovely talking to you.
Well, send Olaf
we miss
love.
You.
Miss you, darling.
When are you say that in Romania? Where is
Bulgaria.
Bulgarian.
Bulgarian. Yes, I'm in Bulgaria.
I wonder what the time
Great
difference is in Bulgaria.
It's wonderful. Okay, roll that outro, and I'm
Early
out.
Bye, Jane. Surprise.
That was kind of fun.
Well, that surprise topic made me feel awkward, and I had a C-section at Reading Hospital, so I didn't get anything to do that.
No hearts here.
By the end of my hospital stay, I was like, sure, come on in, see whatever you want.
My God.
It's here.
That's hysterical.
And still, I'm like, shamed out the window.
Yeah. When you lose all scruples, right? All.
Yeah, well, it was like funny because... Like, the first 15 people that came through, like, can I take a look at your scar? I was like, okay. And I thought they were checking on it.
No.
But then things started to click, and I realized it's a teaching hospital. I was like, are they just letting random interns walk in and look at my C scar?
Look at her stomach. And then 5 points.
And then I didn't care. I was like, whatever. Take a look. It's beautiful work.
I think women, once they start going to GYNs for annual things, how shy can you be when there you are? Yeah. I mean, there's just nothing more.
That in theater, man, shame gone.
Really? Right. I'm still shameful. Catholic guilt.
Really?
It's not going anywhere.
Have some more margarita.
We'll drink some more.
See what happens. See how far that guilt lasts.
Right.
Well, I mean, aside from landscaping, there's other beauty regimens that are kind of important as well. Like, what do you guys do that's like a daily thing for you?
Eyebrows.
Every day?
Eyebrows are huge for me. Well, yeah, because... look at faces and look at old people when their eyebrows get real white, like mine are, and I really have to, you know, kind of fill mine in because it takes some years off your life if you have eyebrows. And I'm doing anything I can to take some layers off my face, but that's my everyday.
Moisturizer.
Yeah,
that's huge.
Moisturizer is big.
I think that's my only beauty regimen. I don't wear makeup because I'm lazy.
Well, you don't hide. Look at your skin. You have this
beautiful
perfect face.
I don't wear foundation. I wear like that BB tinted moisturizer. Yeah. So I literally end up moisturizing my face twice. And,
that's not a bad thing.
I have foundation on for the show, but normally I don't wear it.
No, that's all I wear for this, too.
No,
I don't,
you shouldn't. You don't
I don't like foundation. It's so cakey on me, and then my skin breaks out.
It took me a long time to find some. I'm finding that I'm buying the expensive stuff now.
It's worth it. You get what you pay for.
Yeah, well, I think the older you get, the more you need to... Mm-hmm. Maybe it's because I buy expensive stuff. I think it's working, but I don't know that it's working. I am so rich.
That's how my mom feels. Like, she'll pay a ton of
exactly.
Like, mom,
exactly.
It's the best.
And the jar is gold. So the jar
the
is gold.
The stuff I got at CVS is the best.
Don't ruin my placebo.
Yeah. They're fun. That's fun, funny. That sounds like a rant.
that's
not a rant.
I got a better rant.
You got a better rant? Can we hear it?
Oh, you want my rant now?
Yeah.
Oh, sure.
Why don't we roll the Jane tape?
Oh, that's
right. Okay. Okay, let's do that first.
Well, it's hard to believe we've never been here, but here we are at Reading's
iconic pagoda. It's way up on the hill, so we're going to look around and see what we can see.
Well, it seemed a good thing to go a little mountain climbing before we went to the pagoda. So, come on.
I'm queen of the hill. Isn't that wonderful? Here we are, the highest point in Reading. Well, I guess, no, highest point in Reading. I feel a sense of accomplishment.
Well, I don't know who lives here, but we're going to knock on the door and see if anybody's home and get for a moment out of the wind. Come on.
It's 87 steps to the top of the pagoda, which is where we are now. This is my friend Ferdinand. Say hello. Very good. I guess this was originally going to be a hotel, and then they decided not to make it into a hotel where the depression happened, and something horrible happened, and then they decided not to make a hotel out of it. But it still stands, a memory of the glory that was the Skyline Drive in Reading. I can see my house from here. It's that one, right there. Oh, we're going down the 87 steps. We've already gotten a head start. Follow me. More stairs. Watch your step. Watch the tram car, please. Perhaps this is the bottom. No, it's not. All the houses are getting bigger as we descend.
This must be...
No, it isn't.
More steps. People. I think this is the end.
Yes, we have reached the bottom. After six more steps. Here we are, in the lovely lobby of the pagoda, where you can buy pagoda things.
Remember when I said I could see my house earlier? No. It's much bigger and closer now, but it's still there.
Well, we've had a wonderful time here at the pagoda. We learned some things, we climbed some steps, we had our exercise for sure. And now I think, really, it's time to go have a drink.
That was fun. And see, I forgot we had a fun video on Jane at the pagoda.
Yeah.
That was fun.
I need to get there. I haven't been inside it. I've never been inside it.
Oh, it's great.
I was only inside once for a birthday party.
It's fun.
It's beautiful. It's pretty like, neat. The scenery is... It's a little scary of a drive, though.
Yeah, I've been up there tons of times, but I've never been in the building.
I drove up that mountain in the really serious fog once. It was the most terrifying drive of my life. I was seriously hugging the stair. Yeah. I was really terrified.
It may not have been a good decision.
It was like halfway up. I started up the mountain. Everything was fine. Then it got like completely enveloped in cloud. I'm like, whoa. Wow. And I can't turn around. There's nowhere to turn around. It was weird.
The goat is certainly a unique place.
Jane had a beautiful day for it.
Yeah.
Which is nice. Yes. Now, you know, we discussed our beauty regimens. What do you think Jane's beauty regimen is like? I mean, she's got that flawless makeup that she wears.
She does, and I'm sure it takes her longer.
And nails. Like, Jane's hair always looks good.
Right.
Yeah. A lot of massage sessions with Olaf, I think, helps.
How do you find
it? Well, I bet Olaf's on strike right now. I mean, he's
And you're so beautiful. You don't use makeup, and you don't have to. But do you find, and you're beautiful, too, but do you find, because I know you do use makeup, as you've gotten a little bit older, that what you do changes as far as your makeup is concerned, or have you changed your makeup?
Yeah, here and there. And I'm, well, Everything's like pre-David, post-David.
That depends on what you have time for these
yeah,
days.
Yeah, yeah. I mean,
whatever you can squeeze in.
He was on a jag for a while where he was like, hey guys, 5 a.m. Hey, oh, wow. Let's play. Like, no, you will go back to sleep now. And he does this really cute thing where he used to get up and cry. So he'd wake up and you'd hear, wah! And now he wake up to, mommy, daddy, daddy, mommy. Mommy, wake up! And you're like, all right, I'd be angry, but that's adorable. So it's really what you have time for. And
right.
It's so sweet. Yeah, I have that BB moisturizer stuff. So I moisturize my face after a shower. I put the BB stuff on. I do a light powder, blush, eyeliner, mascara.
That's a lot of work.
And that's it. Yeah. It's 5 minutes.
But I was going to say, yeah, you can do it in no time.
I'm like, wow, that'll take me an hour.
I think what I've found is, again, as I've gotten older, my eyes just sort of fade into nothing. And I spend more time and more makeup on my eyes on a daily basis. Yeah, just to bring them out because they, as you really get old, they really sort of fade into your head. It's just kind of strange.
I focus on my eyes too because they're the thing I like the most on my face. And my glasses, because I have such a high prescription, like shrink them down.
Same.
Ready, watch this. It's magic. 1, 2, 3, bigger eyes.
There they are.
1, 2, 3, smaller.
You have trouble putting your eye makeup on with your glasses off?
No, I have a standing mirror.
Down
yeah,
it.
The mirror is here, and I'm like, yeah, I'm like,
I'm like right on that mirror, face down. It's all fogged up from my breath.
The thing that bothers me is I'll look in the mirror and I'll be like, this looks good. I can make this work for the day.
And then I get out in the car.
And like, oh, I see myself in the mirror. I see myself on TV, and I'm like, who is that? What is that crap? That's not me. That's not what I looked like 10 minutes ago in the mirror.
That's insane.
Everything is different in the daylight.
You look at yourself and you're like, oh, no, like things you totally missed. That's kind of, I know. Do your makeup in the car. That's my recommendation.
Nevertheless, it's fun. I mean,
I like
fun.
Makeup.
I don't like makeup. I'm so lazy.
I enjoy it.
I love
it. I'll do half my face and then I'm like, I don't even want to do the other half because I get exhausted. I do. I'm that lazy. I'm like, oh, well, my eyes painted.
You have this perfect face. I can't imagine why you need it. Look at your eyes. You have natural color in your eyes.
It depends on how much I've slept. I have like a paper bag kind of day. Everybody has the, or you want to put a bag over your head.
I just remember being a little girl and watching my mom put on makeup. And to this day, my mom is still the most beautiful woman I know.
That's cute.
I'd watch her do her hair and put on her makeup, and she's gorgeous, and she just has a flawless way about her, you know? And I always just remember being, you know, thinking, well, okay, I'll be my mom when I grow up, you know? I'm her child. I should be able to look like her. And yeah, I mean, she taught me everything about makeup, and she would put makeup on me when I was little, like a little bit of blush, a little bit of lipstick, and... It's just, so it's kind of like a, you know, this is a girl's club kind of thing.
My mom did that too. I think that's how I got lazy. Yeah. Like, I was like, I'd watch her, I'm like, she looks awesome, but this takes a long time.
My mom has been 15 years.
I'm trying to get to skate rehearsal. Like, yeah, let's move it, please. Something.
I don't know. I'm probably more high maintenance than I think I am. But, I mean, I can be out the door in... Under 30 minutes,
yeah, how you do it.
You know, and redding up my hair and all that. And I remember being younger and, you know, we'd all be standing downstairs and my dad would be like, oh, for the love.
Let's
like,
go.
Mom, it's tomorrow already. Let's go. So there is a compromise with your beauty regimen. You don't need to take 4 hours, but you need to take the time you need to feel like you want to feel.
Yeah.
You know?
Sometimes I do take 4 hours just to do nothing. Like, I'm that draggy. Like, I don't want to leave the house. I like being home.
Oh, you know, in the summer, I'm like that.
Yeah.
In the summer, I like to take my time. Like, right now,
I do take
it's
my time to
in the shower,
no
out of the shower, do my hair, do
because
my makeup, put on clothes.
Get to the kid. In the summer, you don't have to.
In the summer,
that.
I'm like, take a shower. Lounge for a while.
That's me. I'll watch like a TV show.
The Today Show's on. Let's see the segment. What you got for me, Matt Lauer? And then it's like, oh, clothes. Let's do that. Let's put those on.
Yeah, those were a good idea.
Let's dry my hair.
Oh, my gosh. So
by noon, I'm ready to go out.
Yeah, and speaking of beauty regimens, like, and I have this disgusting topic because I know all of us have encountered this at some point. How do you deal with stinky people? Like, people who do not incorporate, like, certain things into their beauty
regimen. Do you run into this in your classrooms at all?
You have to.
Because I
in college, no, not in college.
High
don't.
School kids just stink.
But high school, so. You know where it really was bad? When I taught eighth grade, and they'd come in after gym class. And I finally got to the point where, especially at this time of the year, they're coming in from gym, their hormones are going, so now they're really stinky. Oh, yeah. And I'd say,
tell me about IT.
Tell your mothers you really are old enough to wear deodorant. She needs to buy you deodorant.
This is important.
And don't come into my class until you figure out what that odor is. You need to use it every day, folks. But yeah, it's not kids as much as
adults. I've smelled some really ripe adults.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
It's vicious.
I've had more of an experience with students, and I feel a little bad because some of the students, it's not so much a lack of self-awareness, it's a lack of ability to take care of the problem, if you know what I mean. Like, there just isn't the home structure.
Oh, to yeah, help so that. They just don't know any better.
Yeah, I mean,
they should, but they don't.
It's sad. Yeah.
It is sad.
I have worked with people that looked well-groomed, and I think the real problem is with dry cleaning, that people don't get their clothes dry cleaned. Mm. And so once you've sweated in your winter coat or your winter jacket, it's going to smell until you have it really dry cleaned.
And if you wear it again,
that's still there.
It's bad.
And I don't know. I remember sitting next to a kid in all through school. She sat near me because her names were close together. We were all always in alphabetical. She just smelled so bad.
Aww.
And everyone noticed it. And we tried very hard to be, we gave her bath beads at Christmas, you know, if you were her secret bath beads.
Or soap.
And it was funny. She was her parents were well-educated. She was an only child. She had beautiful clothes, but I don't think they were ever washed or cleaned.
She just kept wearing them.
Yeah.
It's just strange, though, right?
Common sense.
Because aren't you constantly going, you know?
Well, that's what
I mean.
Those people make me self-conscious. I don't know if it's them or me, and I'm kind of like.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Please let it be them.
Exactly.
I'm like, hey, guys, look at the. Look at the board.
Not hitting on the board.
Right. And look at this board over. I'm good right over here.
Or this kind of thing. Oh no, it's you.
Mm-hmm. I'm so relieved when I check myself and it's not me. I'm like, because you don't know, right?
Damn. I will say that, like, I think like in the armpit range, I'm pretty good. But I'm gonna make a little confession. That's what she said tonight. I can get stinky feet.
Really?
I think
that's like a genetic thing.
I'm obsessed with.
I think it is because
I have. Too.
And my mom said that even as a baby, I always had like sweaty feet.
So you just predisposed.
So that's why, like, yeah, when April hits, I'm like, girl is putting on flip flops, and they're not coming off till November. But I have this pair of sneakers that I wear that I call my stinky shoes.
Get stinky.
And I mean, I put them on and I know that magic is going to be happening because I take them off and I'm like, I know everybody's smelling this because I am.
My bartending shoes cause that problem because they're black and they wear black socks. Like, black socks are not good. Yeah. They're just bad.
So, you know, it's just what you deal with. But, you know, when you've changed as many poopy diapers as I have now, smell is a relative thing. You're
really?
Like, no, it's not as bad as the last diaper I changed, so I think we're okay.
Hey, get over that. You'll get over that.
That
guy sitting next to you is going to smell really bad again.
I'll tell you a funny story. Yesterday, my husband took David to the park and played while I went and did something else. Or I went shopping. Yeah, I did the grocery shopping. He's napping when I come home. Wakes up from his nap. I go to change his diaper. And it's kind of in the darkness of his room. And I look at him like, what is all this? I turn on the light. He just had dirt and rocks and pebbles down his diaper.
Ew.
Just in there. And I was like, I was grabbing handfuls. Wow. I've got a boy.
That couldn't have felt good.
He slept in his bed.
Becca just took a picture. Becca's watching tonight. Hi, Becca.
Hey, Becca.
Nico was playing in the dirt with dirt all over his head. I think he was probably eating it, but boys are just gross. They're just born to be that way. They can't help it.
Picks up rocks and throws them in the air.
Yeah, like dirt party.
And goes, wee!
Aww. I love him. That's
and then
so
when
cute.
He gets a little stinky, you know, like I'll hose him off and I'll go, it's bath time. Get upstairs.
Right. Hose him off outside.
We need to de-stink you. Yeah.
De-stink. Oh my gosh, that's so funny. Let's hear a rant from Martha.
All right.
Martha rants.
there with your black face.
Well, you know what? I've been thinking, because there have been so much ranting over the last months with the candidates and their debates and all their nonsense, that I would really like to not have this colder rant anymore, because it's so... I'll tell you what, though, that really has bothered me. In the last couple of weeks, I've been particularly aware of the fact that if I watch something on HBO, or if I watch even Law and Order, and many shows will say mature content, parental guidance suggested, or not appropriate for children, or on HBO, they tell you all the things. It's violence, it's bad language, it's mature nudity, whatever. Mm-hmm. But those debates and those political things that have been going on, there are no disclaimers on those. And we've got kids that have been watching them and hearing their kids and hearing, and I'm not going to mention his name, but one person especially, in my mind, is an incredible bully. And I was thinking I was the only one feeling this way until, the Southern Poverty Law Center did a survey of elementary teachers to find out what effects the candidates' speeches and so forth were having on children. They found that there was a very much higher percentage of bullying toward Latino children. And that Muslim children, especially afraid that somebody was going to kill them or that they were going to be sent away. But it has been been made much worse because of the things that have been said, absolutely unfiltered. Mm-hmm. And we're such hypocrites, because we put that thing on Law and Order and on the HBO shows. We're so worried about what our children might hear, but we don't care if they hear that bully on television say what Mexicans come across the border and the things that he's going to do to Muslims or all Muslims. Mm-hmm. We haven't cared about what that did to our children. And just coincidentally, my daughter sent me my daughter sent me a letter that had a Doonesbury cartoon. If any of you have been reading Doonesbury, I don't think the Reading paper has found them politically correct anymore. But Doonesbury ran a whole series last week of things that particular gentleman has said, and I use the term loosely, in his rants, in his political rants, that kids could use to bully other kids. And they ran three columns of words that he has used that, if you're tired of being bullied, here are things that you could say to kids in return. I'm always concerned about children, and I just think it's kind of hypocritical of us as a nation. We're so concerned about what the rap music they listen to and the HBO things and the cartoons that have to be politically correct and all that. But we're putting these bozos on who are saying all kinds of inflammatory things toward groups of people, and we let our children hear them, and then of course we talk to our children about them. Just incredible to me. That's my rant today, and I'm not ranting, I'm trying to be very...
It's
reasonable.
A statement.
It's a statement.
not a rant. State of a Martha address. State of a Martha address.
It is indeed.
I love it. Martha rants.
I think we have a lot of tweets coming in here. I gotta get on that. Oh my gosh.
Share our tweets.
Let me get on there. Something I wanted to bring up is, I've been thinking about this. What do you think, the most dangerous jobs are? I mean, you two as educators, you have to, although your job sounds pretty safe, I mean, you have a dangerous job too. Bad things happen
mining
in schools all the time.
Being a miner, I mean, besides all the new dangers that we're all under worrying about, I think mining has got to be the most dangerous job. I don't think you could pay me enough to be a miner.
A lot of agricultural jobs are very dangerous.
Oh yeah.
Within agricultural jobs, you're working with equipment that is big and powerful, and you're working with moving parts that if they catch a ring or a shirt sleeve, your whole arm's gone. And so that's very dangerous. Wasn't it put out there that like the most dangerous job was the deep sea crab fisherman or something like that?
Yeah. Deadliest catch. There's a show about it called Deadliest Catch.
I'm good.
What channel it's on.
I think policemen. I mean, as much as we, you know, there are bad apples in every profession, but it's got to be a very dangerous job in many places right now to be a cop.
It's a volatile thing.
Yeah.
Because you don't know if you're going to be received well or if you're going to be attacked. Yeah.
And it's again, like teachers, we are judged by the least of us. You know, there are 500,000 wonderful teachers, but the one that seduced her seventh grade boy, her
that's
seventh
the one
grade
that's
student,
giving everyone
that's
their,
the one that we are all judged by. Right.
That's what we all become.
Right.
Yeah.
That's a shame.
Even though it's a terrible thing.
What do you think is the most dangerous?
You know, I think, honestly, these days, you hear every job is really dangerous. I mean, bank tellers risk their lives every day going into work because people rob banks all the time, store clerks.
Exactly.
Educators, I mean, you have that girl that was just beaten to death in a school fighting over a boy. She fell and hit her head on the sink. So, I mean, like, every job is dangerous, even ones that seem safe. Anything can happen, so.
Is that what they really, has that been the cause of death now that
she hit her head on the sink?
They said they really beat her up.
Yeah, they did beat her up, but her cause of death was because she hit the sink. So, I mean, think of the people that had to split that fight up and, you know, who had to relay the message to her parents. It's just, every job is really kind of awful.
If a teacher sees a fight, they must try to stop it. At least it's Pennsylvania law. But the only thing they really have to say is stop fighting. You don't have to put yourself
in the middle of it.
You have to say loudly, stop fighting, and keep saying it. And so then you can't be judged as negligent.
Okay? Have you ever broken up a fight?
No. No.
Have you?
Mm-hmm. And no.
Really?
Mm-hmm. No.
Years ago, but
No. Yeah. I would walk very slowly and say, stop fighting.
I did once after color guard practice. It didn't happen at color guard practice. We had let them out. They were across the street, down this hill fighting. I saw them and I went running down that hill. Like, I didn't even think.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, that right there, I mean, we all put our lives in our hands doing things like that.
Yeah.
You just never know.
That's, I dislike that mentality of, you know, you wronged me, so I'm going to beat you up.
Right.
There are better ways to do things. There are better ways to do things.
Yeah.
Well, there was
a boy.
Yeah.
And that's, drives me nuts.
Yeah, like,
and
girls,
this is prom,
so
but this is the worst time, right?
This is prom time.
Now, this is when all those kids who were in love in September
and
wanted to get there first, would you go to the prom? And then she said yes, and nobody else has found her, but he's got someone else. He really wants to take her to the prom. She's hanging out by herself.
High school is complicated.
It's horrible. This is, don't you hear these?
High school is complicated.
Oh, I had all kinds of kids crying.
I hear these kids.
I bought my dress in October. You know,
I'm hearing the dealings of things right now.
I think I were a school administrator, I'd have a law that the prom is next week. Nobody gets to ask anyone to the prom
until
3 weeks before. No, because you have to get your nails and you have to do everything.
Or make it like Brigadoon prom.
Yep,
you have no idea where it's coming.
Right.
We're going to announce it 4 days in advance. Make your plans and go. You know what? I think that's a Brigadoon prom. It's a thing. It'll catch on.
It's like what do you call that? Come as you are party. Did you have those when you were kids?
No.
Oh, I guess. Did you know what I'm talking about?
No.
That was a big thing when I was in high school. You'd have a come as you are party. And so at 9:30 on a Saturday morning, they would come to your door and say, come to Nancy's house because we're having a cut. And there you were, you know, Saturday morning, you got your hair
in your pajamas.
In your pajamas. And everybody would come to Nancy's house and we'd have breakfast.
Oh, wait, you have to be told?
I want to have a party like that.
It'd be like spur of the moment.
Hey, maybe next month we can just all film it.
Come as you are, that's what she said.
Party at my house, come as you are.
Right.
I have been waiting for the opportunity to wear pajamas on this show. This is happening.
Can we have a pajama party next month?
I've been asking.
Let's do it.
Yes, pajama party.
Oh,
we're doing
sure.
it. Doing it.
Okay.
I bet Jane has some really
good.
You got
a home viewer.
Ooh,
somebody
who
remembers
come
at
excellent. Somebody who remembers come at your parties.
I home viewer.
Hi, how are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. I just wanted to call in and say that my name's Jill. And I live in Wyomissing, and I watch your show almost every month, and
that's
I really
awesome.
Enjoy it.
Thanks,
Jill.
Thank you.
That's awesome that you watch all the time. I hope we entertain you.
You always do.
No, I'm so glad.
We try. We have so much fun here, so I'm glad that you have fun with us, too.
Well, it definitely comes through, so...
Very cool. Thank you for calling.
Thank
That's so
you.
Cool.
Thanks,
yeah, Jill. You're welcome. And I also wanted to just do a quick plug here. So April is National Poetry Month.
Yes.
And for those of you watching or on the show who may not know, BardFest is happening through kind of the middle of May in Berks County. So I just want to give a quick plug for that, too.
I was one of the original organizers of the first BardFest.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool.
Yes, I was.
Who knew?
Way, way back.
Surprise. Thank you for sharing that information.
Yes.
Yeah, you're welcome. And ladies, keep doing what you're doing. It's great.
Thank you.
Keep watching what care. We do. We've got more tweets.
Wow.
All right, let's see what we got. Some tweets.
Tweets?
Yeah. Let's see. Give me a second here. I'm not that skilled with the tweet.
My chocolate lab tweets.
He Your chocolate lab.
A chocolate
Ooh,
lab.
Is that Chooch?
Yes. Chooch he has tweets? A friend in who has an Instagram account in Toronto, another chocolate lab. His name is Duckman. And he looks very much like Chooch. And we communicate through our tweets.
That's so cool. I love that he tweets. I'm going to have to friend Chooch.
10 minutes.
You know, Becca has said here on the Twitter that she has, I can vouch for this, she will not go to important events unless she gets her eyebrows done. She refuses. She
Absolutely.
Refused to go to a wedding once where she was running a spotlight or something. She was like, I'm not coming if I don't get my eyebrows waxed. It's
wow,
important.
It's very important.
You got to do your, you got to be, what the kids say, on fleek.
On fleek.
I don't know.
Yes.
That's what my kids say. I'm like, what is that?
I don't think my kids are qualified to use that word.
No, that's a dumb word.
That's not a word they get
it's
to use.
It's not a word. And someone else, R.V. Kramer, said B.O. isn't that bad, but he has a problem with adults who smell of cigarettes. Having to sit at work with that smell is awful.
That's true.
I can't agree more. That's
Absolutely.
The most awful
Absolutely.
Smell. Especially yeah. some, like, I don't know about you guys, but I did used to smoke, and
yeah,
so I noticed
too.
It smell
yes.
like
yes.
majorly
yes.
after I stopped
smoking. I think
smoking.
It offends me more as an ex-smoker than it would
you
have
smell
if I were
it more
a non-smoker.
Sharply.
Mm-hmm.
I smell it on kids' homework.
Oh,
turn in their work,
yeah.
and I'll go to grade it, and it wafts up, and I'm
Ew.
Like, "Whoo, oh. okay." And
so gross.
Yeah,
yeah. I don't abide by smoking.
I don't see as much smoking on Albright's campus which is kind of neat. I don't see a lot of kids. Yeah. When I see a kid smoking, it always strikes me as odd because I don't
odd.
See it very
mm-hmm.
often.
Yeah, I don't.
That's a good
I don't
sign.
Either anymore.
Becca shared a picture of her stinky little boy
oh.
in the dirt playing in the
oh, oh,
I saw
dirt.
That picture.
Oh,
that's great.
Perfect.
Does she mind if we?
No,
he's adorable.
He's so adorable. And like 2 seconds later, she took a full face picture. Lots of dirt everywhere.
And by the way, Chooch likes dirt. He loves to dig in
Chooch
the dirt.
Chooch likes dirt? Mm-hmm.
Chooch likes dirt.
Uh-oh. Becca's husband wants to come to our jammy party.
Ooh, all right.
Too.
It really is going to be a party now.
It is a party.
I think we need to do that. Sell tickets.
So
everyone, we can come to a pajama party next episode.
Ooh, I'll
Jamie,
make pancakes.
You know this is a good idea. You
That's
love
it.
It sounds like a fundraiser. Hey, that's what she said, fundraiser.
Right. What else is new?
What else is new?
Yeah.
Any shows you guys are watching right now?
Well, no. And the reason why is because I've been held by the neck at Colored Art.
Yeah, I'm sure. We've just finished watching The Americans.
Americans. You know, I've heard good things about that.
Well,
I like
you know,
Carrie Russell.
I'll tell you what. After a while, I like Carrie Russell, too. I hated everybody on the show.
if they had died,
I wouldn't have cared. They
like,
would just...
Really?
Really. It's a
wow,
very, it's
Martha,
a very well-written
a
show.
Statement.
No, because it's a really well-written show. And
Except
it's just
for that.
So... Well, it's
So
like,
they're real characters.
They are real characters. It's, you know, back in the, you know.
Yeah.
But what I did watch the other day, if you haven't seen it, there have been reviews of so forth, the Anita Hill, the hearing for Clarence Thomas.
I remember that.
Do watch it. Do watch it if you get a chance.
I was listening about it on NPR.
It's called Confirmation.
Yeah. They did, because... was that Nina Stotemeyer on NPR? She helped to break that.
Yes.
And so they were interviewing her on NPR, and it was really insightful. Like,
it's
really
very
good.
Well done. And you know, I do remember it, but I just read a very cranky, snarky comment by a very conservative columnist who said, well, they,
it.
You know, it was just not fair to Mr. Thomas to Clarence Thomas because it made him look guilty. Well, frankly, there was no reason for Anita Hill to come out and do what she did. She got, it was no game right. for her. It ruined her life. It, you know, but it's very well done. And you will be chagrined. And the thing I was wondering, if it happened today, would those senators have responded differently?
Makes really you wonder.
Interesting.
That's a good
yeah,
point.
Very interesting.
Interesting.
It's well done.
Well, I don't know if I told you guys this, but my husband and I gave up cable.
Good really? For you.
Yeah, we have basic, and we have internet, and then we have
and you could
Netflix
stream everything.
And we have Netflix and Hulu.
Yeah,
and we have
you don't
Pandora.
Really need much else?
No. Yeah, and it's been great. No. We'll put the music on, and David loves to dance. Yeah. But so we're discovering different shows, and right. Netflix is great. It has yeah. all these original shows. I just discovered Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt.
Oh my gosh!
Oh my gosh! I posted it on Facebook.
I love Kimmy Schmidt.
Like I'm sitting here
my
right now
got
thinking,
me hooked
I wonder
that.
If I can squeeze an episode in before I go to bed for school because it's that good. It's
Titus
so
is my favorite.
Funny. Titus is hilarious.
Her roommate. Oh my gosh.
But I kind of like the Carol King character.
She's crazy too.
She's so funny.
Yeah, you guys got to watch it.
She's a great actress. If you're not watching this show, oh boy, Hattie, you need
it's
to go watch it.
It's a lot of good stuff.
Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt.
Yeah. It's good. And Game of Thrones of just started back up, so we're like, yes! And we don't have HBO, so our plan is to subscribe to HBO just for Game of Thrones, and then cut off the subscription.
But you can get it. You'll be able to stream it after a while.
Yeah, that's the idea. So, like right around July, when it's almost over, we're gonna get our subscription,
watch anything,
binge it all, and go
right.
to town.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So that's our plan. But right now, Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt, man,
five
that's a good
minutes.
Show.
5 minutes. Wow. We only have 5 minutes.
Only
left.
5 minutes.
Time
left.
Flies, right? When you're having fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So now that you don't have cable, like how are you going to watch your sports teams?
I mean, I...
Do you even follow any sports teams?
No.
Hey, guilty. Martha does, though, because she's got a dog named Chooch.
Yeah. No, we're...
It's painful. The Phillies, painful.
It's been a bad time.
They did beat
them.
The Mets once, right?
That's all it takes, right?
Call them the comeback kids.
Runs,
they'll come
but
back.
Chooch is still playing. Love Chooch.
Still
love
still
Chooch.
Good.
Yeah, they have some pretty cool players.
No, we watch sports. It's tough because we're Pittsburgh fans, so whenever there's a...
You have to be real quiet in your neighborhood.
Yeah. No! Oh my gosh, you wouldn't even believe it how many Steelers fans I see walking
loud.
Around. Like, there's so many intelligent
people
in this city.
Well, your choice is the Eagles. The Eagles are the Steelers.
Like yours too. Fantastic! That's great. But no, we are Pittsburgh
towels.
Fans. Yeah, but no, and with that was a concern. My husband is very much into sports, so I was like, "Are you going to be okay with this?" And he's like, "I'll figure it out. If it's really a problem,
can
we'll
get
go
it
back."
On his iPad.
He has really learned to make it work.
Yeah.
So he when games are on the regular stations, he's going to watch those, and he gets things live streaming. He watches a lot of soccer, international
soccer,
so that's online anyway.
Yeah, exactly.
He can watch everything still.
Yeah, I think he's had a little bit of a loss, but he's.
He's adjusting.
He's adjusting. He's learning to deal with it.
It's different.
And what it's done is I got pretty desensitized to sports because it was sports all the time. And when it wasn't a sports event, it was a show talking about sporting. And I was just like, make this stop now. But now that we don't have that constant sports channel streaming, it makes it a more special event.
Yeah.
And now I'm kind of liking sports again. And I'm getting back into it. And I'm watching hockey games with him.
Good.
See? David watched the last hockey game with him. And he would cheer when Jesse would cheer. And that was good.
That's
I was like,
fun.
Okay, now we're finding the specialness in these things again. Because it's not just this constant
it's all
flow.
The time.
It's, okay, we have to
overkill.
Consciously think about it. So
right.
I think that makes sports better. And we're making a conscious effort this year to do more live sports.
That'll be fun.
It's more fun to be there and smell it and
see
it.
Hey, we should go to a hockey game.
I would love to go to a hockey game.
I'd love that. And we just went to a Fighting Phil's game.
And they'll let us skate on the ice.
Well, I'm not going to try that.
Look, I already roller skated for you people. You didn't go on the roller skates. I
know, but I have since. I have since.
Have you?
Yeah,
good for you. That's right. You said you were going to.
Yeah.
Good for you.
I was just out of it that day.
You have 2 minutes.
I simply didn't feel like it.
It happens.
So I think we should make a mention. I mean, it's the 3-year bombing anniversary for the Boston Marathon. Like, it's been 3 years.
Wow.
Can you believe that?
No.
2 minutes.
Yeah, it's been 3 years.
Incredible.
That's incredible.
And a lot of the victims of the bombing came back and ran, or if they couldn't run, they participated another way. It was very strong. Was
yeah. And what, 3 years since Sandy Hook, or 4 years since Sandy Hook?
Yeah, I think it's four.
And those people are still hurting. I mean, they will hurt always. I just can't imagine. I heard some of the siblings of the victims that were interviewed. These were little kids. They're still little kids, but some of their sisters or brothers were killed, and this one little boy is just, he's lost.
That's a shame.
He's just
That's
really
so sad.
Awful. Again, it's hard children to recover from those things. Do to children. Yeah, absolutely.
So we only have like 2 minutes left, but is there anything that we want to plug? I know the Why Nots are in May.
Yeah, the Why Nots
are May 25th. And for those of you who don't know, the Why Nots is a celebration of musical theater, high school musical theater in Berks County. It's at
Sovereign Center.
Thank you very much. Just drawing a blank. On May 25th, tickets are for sale. You should go. Twin Valley will be there. A lot of the other schools in Berks County will be there.
But I think that's our isn't that our next show?
Our next show is Monday, May 23rd at 9.
Oh, the 3rd.
Right. So I will remind you to go get your tickets.
Yeah.
I'd also like to make a shout out to Anthony from the Fighting Phils, who I got to see on Saturday night.
Oh, cool.
He was on our show.
Mm-hmm.
Remember Anthony?
We did like Anthony. That
and
was
we
fun.
Also want to tell you that Cooper was adopted.
Yay. Thank you for adopting Cooper, sweet dog. So we want to say goodbye. Thank you for joining us tonight. It's been an awesome night.
We love you, Lindsay,
Tyler, and Joan in our studio here.
We miss you, Jane.
We miss Jane. Thank you for calling.
But good
Jane.
Job.
Who?
You.
Oh, yes. Thanks.
Good job.
Thanks for steering the ship, Captain.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
That was fun.
Good job.
I'm glad to take one for the team.
I think we're still
good night, everyone.
Bye.